Hello friends, so in the last lecture we discussed about hydraulic brakes. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about master cylinder and fluid reservoir. First we will discuss master cylinder. At the end of the last lecture we discussed about the basic structure of master cylinder. We'll discuss it again in this lecture. So actually first we'll start by some piston cylinder diagrams. First diagram is like this. This is your cylinder, the boundary of the cylinder, and consider this as your piston. Okay, the push rod applies force here. This is your push rod only. Force is being applied here to the piston. Then what happens? There is a arrangement like this in your piston. These are some small holes. Piston is like this, and here are your cup type seal. This is known as cup type seal. It is actually a seal, and these are small holes which has made in the piston for a specific purpose. We'll discuss it now only. This is your piston. Okay, so the force is applied here. This is our first case. Now see that here you have fluid filled, okay, your brake oil. So as force is applied here, this cup type seal will be moved outside, or it will seal your holes, these holes. Okay, are you understanding? By the pressure of the fluid present here, the cup type seal will pack the holes. It will move towards the boundary and it will seal this boundary. Okay, like this as shown in diagram. Okay, so we can say that when the force is applied here, the seal expands outward against the cylinder. In this case, against the cylinder, bore walls, seal expands outward against the cylinder bore walls when the fluid is pressurized. When the fluid is pressurized, making a tight seal. You can see that it is making a airtight, or it is making a tight seal so that fluid can't enter these holes anymore. What is the significance of those holes? We are going to discuss it. Making a tight seal. Okay, so this was first condition when the force is applied here, or when the pedal is pressed by some force. So during that condition, our force will be applied here, or push rod will be pushed inside, and this will be the case. But in second case, that is while retraction means when the pedal is left, or when the force is left, the force is not applied in the pedal. Okay, so in the returning case, what happens? This is our cylinder. During the retraction, this is our piston. Okay, this condition is piston retraction. These are our holes, small holes. Here you will understand the significance of these holes. This is your seal. Now what happens? This piston is moving this side, so due to that the fluid is present here, so your fluid flows from this container, means this cylinder, towards this side through these small holes, and it moves to this side. This is actually fluid movement. Okay, so significance of these small holes is this only, that while retraction of the piston, What happens is the fluid present in the secondary cup, it moves through these small holes towards here, and your cup type seals also, it contracts like this. Okay, so this is the case of sudden retraction, or retraction also easily in simple words we can say. When it happens suddenly, then it will be more the fluid movement will be more good and rapid. Then what happens actually in this case, that these small holes do have one also advantage, that it prevents air bubbles from forming. It prevents air bubbles formation in front of seal. Okay, the air bubbles, you might analyze this, that if the air bubbles will form, then the movement, then we have to do move movement. We saw it in the hydraulic brakes concept also, that during movement, what movement have to do, it have to all these small gaps or holes which we are present, more the holes present, we have to perform more movement. Okay, so movement are actually holes are actually, air bubbles are actually a disadvantage for us. So we need no air bubbles, or up to lesser extent we can avoid it, so we should avoid. So these small holes have one advantage, that it prevents the air bubbles formation in the front of the seal. Okay, then fluid inlet port, we saw it in last lecture, today also we'll saw that fluid inlet port keeps fluid behind the seal at all times. Fluid inlet port, the fluid is always behind the seal. Fluid inlet port keep fluid behind the seal at all times. So these three points are the main points while retraction. The retraction is sudden and it prevents air bubble from formation in front of the seal. Then fluid inlet port keeps the fluid behind the seal at all times. And we can see this by a diagram also. Just see the diagram here. Just see this diagram. What happens here? This is actually a simple single master cylinder which we saw in the last lecture also. This is your push rod. It is written over here. These are your dust boots. Then this is your piston. This is your secondary cup. This is your fluid reservoir. Then this is your filler cap we can say. These are two holes. First is your fluid inlet port, and second hole is compensating port. Okay, these are your return springs which are used while retraction. Okay, this is your primary cup, and residual pressure check valves. We'll talk about this also. Then what happens, as soon as the pressure is applied, push rod moves inside. This is what your piston end. So this piston end is present at just the, this is called as a lip. This lip is present at the end of the fluid inlet port. Okay, so as soon as this is pressed, this fluid inlet port is opened. So fluid moves to this secondary cup. Then this fluid present in the primary cup is pressurized. So due to this pressure, fluid is pressurized through the brake lines to the caliper. Okay, so while retraction, what happens, that this piston moves backward. You can see this. What happens, this piston moves while retraction, this piston will move in this direction or backwards. So what happens, that this is the what your cup seal. Okay, this is our cup seal, and these are small holes present. You can see, if you are able to see, there are small holes which are present in the piston. So while retraction, the fluid present here will move through the holes to your primary cup, and due to the pressure difference, it can move to the filler cup also, or reservoir. So this is the main mechanism of your single master cylinder. Okay, now Now we saw, we have discussed what is the basic concept of master cylinder. So now we are moving on to the types of master cylinder. Master cylinder are basically of three types, which we'll discuss. What are those types? First is your tandem master cylinder. Second is your fast fill master cylinder. And third is your dual master cylinder. These three types we'll discuss. First is tandem master cylinder. What is this tandem master cylinder? In tandem master cylinder, it is a type of master cylinder with two pistons. In single master cylinder, we discussed one piston. In tandem master cylinder, we have two piston with, we have two piston in a single bore. In tandem master cylinder, we have two pistons in a single bore. Okay, and it is used in modern racing cars. We'll see the diagram of this also. It have two pistons in a single bore and it is used in modern racing cars. So we can see the diagram of tandem master cylinder like this. This is a tandem master cylinder. Okay, rather it will be more clear in this diagram. So in this type of tandem master cylinder, we can see that these are, you have two pistons, or these are your two reservoirs which are attached to the pistons. Here are your two pistons and these are your outlet ports. Okay, this is your cover, this is your externally your master cylinder and reservoir will look like this. And what is the internal mechanism? Internally it looks like this. See here, these are your two reservoir. This is your reservoir diaphragm. This is called secondary reservoir. This is called primary reservoir. These are your two pistons. This is two return springs. Okay. This is your inlet valve, filler valve. And these are your compensating valve, primary and secondary. This is your push rod. Okay. As soon as pressure is applied, these two will act as two independent, okay, single master cylinders. So the mechanism is same as we have discussed. This is our primary compensating port, this is primary reservoir, retaining ring, then hydraulic push rod, secondary cup, primary piston, primary cup, returning spring, then this is a stop bolt also we'll use, then this is a secondary cup, secondary piston, primary cup, returning spring, secondary compensating port, secondary reservoir, reservoir diaphragm. Okay, clear. Okay, so this was our tandem master cylinder. We saw the diagram also. Now second type is fast fill master cylinder. What is actually this fast fill master cylinder? Actually it has a stepped primary or fast fill bore. It has a stepped bore, it's a stepped primary or fast fill bore. This master cylinder has a stepped primary or fast fill bore. Okay, and it has a fluid control valve also. What is this fluid control valve? We'll see. And one advantage, major advantage which it has is that it is used to increase the fluid displacement, which we saw AP into MP, which is AP is what? Area of piston, and MP is the movement of piston. Usually we take it in inches. To increase the fluid displacement, during initial pedal travel. Increase the fluid displacement during initial pedal travel. Fluid displacement we discussed in first lecture, okay, in second lecture in the hydraulic brakes part. To increase the fluid displacement during initial pedal travel, this is the advantage of fast fill master cylinder. Okay, so we'll see the diagram of fast fill master cylinder. It is like this. So a fast fill master cylinder, we can see that it has a stepped or in somewhat inclined primary or fast fill bore, okay, like this. And it has a fluid control valve here. This is called as a fluid control valve. Okay, so in case of the pressure difference, these fluid control valve, actually it helps in taking the fluid from your bore to the master cylinder. This fluid control valve has this work. The mechanism is simply like that only, and the advantage which we get is it increases the fluid displacement during initial pedal travel. During the initial pedal travel, the fluid displacement is increased by using this. How it increases? Since we have a stepped primary bore, so the fluid pressure normally increases due to this stepped, means the fluid moves faster towards this end, and since it moves faster, so the pressure, as soon as we apply the pressure, the fluid moves faster, means initially we get a faster rate of fluid displacement here. That's why tandem master cylinders, that's why fast fill master cylinders have a stepped primary bore. Okay, so generally for increasing the fluid displacement for initial pedal travel, these type of master cylinders are used. Now moving on to our third type, which is a dual master cylinder. Now what is a dual master cylinder? Dual master cylinders are basically used in mostly in racing cars. Most racing cars have this type of master cylinders. Okay, dual master cylinders have two single master cylinder side by side connected by a link, with a link between them called balance bar. Okay, dual master cylinder have two single master cylinders connected side by side with a balance bar. And what advantage it have? It allows ratio of forces between the front and the rear brakes to be adjusted. It allows the ratio of the forces between the front and rear brakes to be adjusted. How it happens? You can understand it. Adjusted. Okay, so two single master cylinders we use in dual master cylinder, which are connected by a link. So one master cylinder will go to rear wheels and another master cylinder bore will be connected to your front wheels. So since they are separate single master cylinders, so we can control the ratio of forces, whatever fluid means. How we can control the ratio of forces? We can adjust the amount of or the pressure of fluid which are going to the rear and front wheels. So by adjusting the fluid pressure, we can control the ratio of forces which will apply at the front and rear brake pads. Okay, so that's why this type of master cylinders is mostly used in racing cars, because this type of adjustment is necessary there. And adjustment is why it is necessary. Adjustment is necessary because in racing track, mainly due to track conditions, mainly track conditions changes suddenly. So due to the changing track conditions or variation in car setup, This type of adjustment in master cylinder is needed. Okay, so this was about dual master cylinder. So this was all about master cylinder. First we discussed about our basic concepts of master cylinder while retraction and while the application of force. Then we discussed about the types of master cylinder: tandem master cylinder, fast fill master cylinder, dual master cylinder. Tandem master cylinder with two pistons with a single bore. Okay, then we saw fast fill master cylinder, it is a stepped master cylinder. Then we saw dual master cylinder, which is used mostly in racing cars. Okay, it have a two single master cylinder and they are attached by a link called as balance bar, and it allows the ratio of force to be adjusted. So this was all about our master cylinder. I hope you liked this tutorial was informative to you and helpful for you. So thanks for watching.
Our next tutorial will be all about brake fluid and fluid reservoir.